Hey, what is up guys? Welcome back to another Minecraft Java video. Today we're going to be taking a look at a shader pack for Minecraft Java Edition version 1.17. And this one is called BSL Shaders. And I have been using the shader pack for several years now. And it's actually one of my favorite shader packs for Minecraft Java Edition. And today I'm going to show you how to install this shader pack for Minecraft and how to play with this shader pack for Minecraft Java Edition. And today I'm going to show you how to download BSL shaders for Minecraft Java 1.17 and then how to install it onto your Minecraft Java Edition game and how to create a new world and play with BSL shaders enabled for Minecraft Java Edition 1.17. Okay, so as you can see, I've currently got the BSL shaders enabled. I am using Optifine as well to run this, but I'll also show you guys how to install this with the Iris shaders as well, because that is another option we can use to install shaders at the moment. Optifine is in the preview version at the moment, and even though it does support shaders, it's not the final version, so you can go ahead and use Iris shaders as well if that's what you like using. Okay, so as you can see, BSL shaders is actually a really nice shader pack. It gives a lot of unique features to the game, and as you can see, we've got the shadows coming in here. Let me just change the time of day to day, so we've got the sun's reflection coming in there. As you can see, we've got the sun's rays coming in through the gap there, the trees, and it looks really nice. I really like the shader pack because it's so simple yet so detailed at the same time. And everything just looks so lively in this. You can also use Silda's shader pack, but I think that's too vibrant compared to this one. So if you are looking for an experience which is closer to the vanilla Minecraft game, but then it also has cool reflections, cool sunshine and shadows, then I think BSL is the way to go, definitely. There is a reason why some of the most popular Minecraft streamers use BSL shaders. People like PewDiePie or other popular Minecraft streamers are using BSL shaders in their online streams, and if you've ever seen one of the time-lapse stream videos on YouTube for Minecraft, you would have noticed that they also tend to use some sort of shader pack, and most likely it is BSL shaders which they're using. Okay, so as you can see, we've got some really nice reflections there in the water that's happening. Let me just go up a bit and have a look at the whole world. You can see that the grass as well, it looks really nice, especially with the shadows coming on top of the grass there. You can see a lot of detail is going on with the shadows there. And as you can see, it started raining. Rain also looks unique as well. It's not like the typical rain that you do see in Minecraft, as you can see there. So the rain is also quite realistic there. We have a look at the water there. I'll just change it to clear again. As you can see, the sun's rays on the water just look amazing. We've got a bit of lens flare there as well. The clouds also look really nice. They are moving as well, as you can see. And they look so realistic compared to the default game as well. The sun also looks nice. I do like the reflections that are happening in the water there. It just looks so cool. And as you can see on the top left there, I have enabled the FPS counter. And I am able to run this with no problems with over 60 frames per second in the game. And everything just runs so smoothly and nicely. I think BSL shaders are not that heavy on your graphics, and they run quite nicely as well. As you can see, the grass is also moving, and so are the trees as well. So if you guys are looking to change your current Minecraft experience, go for a shader pack that is unique and gives you loads of cool features such as reflections and shadows. I would highly recommend BSL shaders. There is some lava over here, so let's turn it to nighttime and have a look at the lava, how it looks. As you can see, we've got the glows there as well. Looks quite nice. And the night sky looks really nice as well. it's a nice experience to have the nighttime with this shader pack on. And you can also see the fog there in the distance. Looks quite nice. All right, so what I'm going to do now, guys, I'm going to show you how to download BSL shaders and install them for Minecraft Java Edition 1.17. I'm going to use Optifine as the default, but I'm also going to show you how to install BSL shaders using the Iris shaders that are also available for Minecraft Java Edition 1.17. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is we need to download Java, because that's really important, because we're going to use Java to install Optifine, and we're going to use it to install Iris shaders as well. So any jar file that you use, Java is quite important. So just start typing in java.com into your internet browser. Just click on Java download, start free download. Let's wait for that to finish downloading. I'm going to open up the file. The screen is going to go black because it does ask you for permission to install it. So let's go ahead and click the install button and wait for that to finish. All right, so as you can see, it does say you have successfully installed Java. So any previous version that I did have, it's overwritten that and it's installed the latest version. So I don't need to worry about Java now. Let's close this down. Now, if we go back to our internet browser, so the next thing we're going to do, we're going to download BSL shaders. So in the search bar, if you just start typing in BSL shaders and wait for that to load the results. And if you look for the link, which is bitslablab.com, that is the main author's website. So if you click on that link, it should come up with a website like this. And don't worry, guys, I will leave a link in the description for all of these web pages, so you don't have to go around searching for them. You can just click the links in the description and it will bring you to these pages. Okay, so if we click on download and if we scroll down where it says download BSL version 8.0.01, if we click on this link here, it should start downloading BSL shaders. All right, so as you can see, BSL versions 8.0.01.zip has finished downloading, so we can close this down. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do, we're going to download Optifine. And if you just start typing in Optifine in the search bar, it's normally the link, which is optifine.net. So just click on this link here, wait for that page to load up. And if we go to the download section for Optifine, you will notice that it's currently in the preview version. So for 1.16.5, we have the final full version, but for version 1.17, of Minecraft, we only have the preview version. And if you click on changelog, you will notice that it does say not compatible with Forge. However, they have fixed loads of stuff for the shaders, so you can go ahead and download and use this for shader packs. All right, so if we click on the preview versions again, and where it says Optifine preview 24, so as of today's date, this is the latest preview version. In the future, you might get a full release, so obviously go ahead and download that one. But for now, I'm going to click on this bit here, which says Mirror, and I'm going to download the Preview Edition version pre-24. I'm going to click on Download. And it's going to start downloading, obviously, as you can see there. And it's finished downloading. Okay, so if we close this down, now let's search for Iris shaders. And if we just start typing in Iris shaders as well. And the link we need to go to is irisshaders.net. So let's go to that one. And I'm going to click on download now, and the link I need to click on again is this one, which says download universal jar, and wait for that to start downloading. And as you can see, it's finished as well. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to place all of these files onto my desktop, and then I'm going to start installing them and copying over the shader pack file. Okay, so I have placed the files on my desktop, and I'm going to install Optifine first of all, and then I'm going to move on to Iris shaders as well. And just to confirm that you don't actually have to install Iris shaders if you don't want to. It's completely optional, so you can decide to keep Optifine and install the shaders using that, or you can decide to use Iris shaders. So you've got the option to use both, basically. I'm just going to show you how to do them with both for this tutorial video, but obviously if you only want to use one of them, that's completely fine. Okay, so if we want to right-click on the Optifine jar file, select where it says open with, and then select what it says here, which is Java Platform SE Binary. And it should open up the installer just fine because we have got the latest version of Java installed. Click on install and it should finish installing it. And as you can see, it says Optifine is successfully installed. Click on OK and that will close down. Now, we do the same for Iris shaders as well. Right click, open with, and then select Java Platform SE Binary. and you should get the Iris installer. And in the drop down on the top, if we select version 1.17, game version is 1.17, leave everything as default as it is, and then click on install, and it should start downloading and installing this onto your Minecraft game. And as you can see, it's really quick. It's now saying installation succeeded. So let's go ahead and close this down. Now, what we need to do, if we place the BSL shader pack into a shader pack folder in the Minecraft default directory, and to do this, what we need to do is if we open up Minecraft Launcher, click on installations. Now you will see it says Optifine here, and it also says Iris and Sodium for 1.17. If we click on the folder icon on any one of these selections here, it should open up your default Minecraft game directory. And if you look for a folder that says shader packs, now chances are that if you're installing Minecraft for the first time or shader packs for the first time, you might not have this folder. So if you right click, go and do new and then select folder, and then just rename that folder to shader packs, as you can see how it says over here, that should have a shader packs folder. And what we need to do now is if we move the BSL file into the shader packs folder there, as you can see, I've got the BSL shader in that in the shader packs folder. Close that down, go back to the Minecraft launcher. And with Optifine selected in the drop down on the bottom left here, just click on play. Alright, so once the game has loaded, you'll see at the bottom left here it says Minecraft version 1.17 modded. And if we go to options and then video settings, there will be a button here that says shaders, so you'll know that Optifine is working as it should. And if we select shaders and make sure that BSL has been selected here and it's been highlighted, so just click on done. Now we can go ahead and create our new world, so just click on create new world. And then we'll create a default survival world just to show you that BSL shaders do work with that as well. So wait for that to load up. And there we go. As you guys can see, it's now loaded me into a default survival world. And BSL shaders have been installed and are working fine. You can see my shadow there at the bottom, and everything just looks so nice. We can see the water reflection there in the distance as well, and everything just looks really cool. You can see through that gap there the sun's rays coming in as shown before. Alright, so I'm going to show you guys how to enable this for the Iris shaders as well, if you do want to go down the path of using that instead of Optifine. So let me just close this down. Alright, so let me open up the launcher again, and this time I'm going to select Iris and Sodium for 1.17, the drop down, as you can see here. Just wait for that to load up. You will see that it does say downloading, so when you're loading Iris shaders for the first time, you might see that message there. Alright, so we are now in the game, and as you can see on the bottom left here, it does say Minecraft version 1.17/fabric and then modded. So we can see that Iris shaders, because it's using fabric, it has been installed and it is working fine. Now if we click on options, go to video settings, and the area for shader packs is now over here. So if we go ahead and select the option for BSL shaders and then click on apply, and then done. So obviously you do have different options here that you can select. Right, let's close this down. Let's go back into single player, and let's go back into our world that we created earlier. And just like Optifine, it should load up the game with BSL shaders showing as well. And there we go. As you guys can see, BSL shaders have been loaded now and everything is running fine. And we are getting nice frame rates there, as you can see there on the top left, getting close to 170 to 200 FPS there. Now obviously if your computer it's not as powerful. You may not get that much. However, this BSL shaders, they do run quite nicely on low to medium PCs, and also obviously they do run nicely on the higher end PCs as well. So I think it's a good all-round shader pack to download and install and try out in your game. If you guys did find this video useful, please do give it a like. And if you have any questions or queries about this shader pack, do leave them in the comment section below. Also, do let us know what is your favorite shader pack and whether you like using Optifine or Iris shaders. And also, please do subscribe to the channel to help support it, help it grow. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.